It's all part of his pregame routine. About an hour before the game, you can find Derek Fisher at the last place you'd expect to find an NBA star, Chapel.
Why do you go to Chapel?
Honestly, it's just an important part of who I am. I was born and raised in a church background. I was born and raised in a family that believed in God and believed in the Word of God. To me, it's just a part of my DNA.
Fisher is not alone. Many NBA stars pray before games, including Dikembe Mutombo, Lindsey Hunter, Dwight Howard, Michael Redd, Bobby Jackson, just to name a few. In fact, all NBA teams have a chaplain. Today, you're going to meet two. Rick Carville, who's been the team chaplain of the Lakers for the past 26 years, and Robert Cummings, the chaplain of the Clippers.
Rick, did you ever think that religion would lead you to be around all these basketball greats?
No, never thought about it. Never thought about it.
I asked Pastor Harville if he's ever surprised to see a guy who doesn't have the best reputation coming before a game and pray.
Yes, it blows my mind to see some of the guys that come in from other teams and you say, this guy? You know, you say it in your mind, but they're really nice guys.
That have money to buy anything they want. But the Bible tells us, what profiteth a man if he gains the whole world but loses his own soul? He didn't gain anything.
I feel as though I gained so much out of it that, you know, I look forward to going the next time. You know, with our schedule, it's hard for us to get into the house of the Lord in terms of actually going to church.
Sundays.
You know, Sundays we play games, we practice in the mornings.
Sometimes in your job, the players come up to you and ask for advice that have nothing to do with basketball or religion. How does that role come on to you?
Wow. That must be the Clipper players, because my players...
they never come to talk to you?
Yeah, they talk to us.
Other players I talk to tell me that praying helps them prepare for the game. But faith has much more power. As Pastor Cummings shared with me his own story, how his religion saved his life.
My mother didn't raise me. I've never seen my father at all in my life. All I seen was violence, drugs. My first drug was age 11, which they call barbiturates, Red Devils, those that know about those things, age 11 on barbiturates.
As the years went by, his addiction to drugs got worse and worse.
What point did you get with the cocaine? Like, did you almost lose your life? Did you lose a job? Did you lose your house?
Oh, I lost. Once you take that first hit, once you take that first tote, you know, on drugs, what happens is that you try to chase that, but you'll never, ever reach it.
His life was going fast, nowhere, until one night, he says, he had a vision.
I had a visitation from the Lord Jesus Christ come in my room and told me, you might say, wow, that happened? Oh, believe me, I'm here standing 27 years later, removed from that drug life and the things that involved, that went on with the drugs. And the voice said this to me, and I heard this. It said, get up and throw your dope away.
Since that night, Pastor Cummings has been drug-free for 27 years. He says anyone can do it. In his case, it was the Bible that got him back on the right track.
You cannot live the life that you need to live without the Word of God. Cannot do it. It is totally impossible.
From the Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles, Elie Seckbach reporting.